Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Stan Houston with the Master Entrepreneur, and also today for the Praying Planet. I waited all day on Monday as the coronavirus took full effect in the United States and around the world. I said all of the politics and all of the news and all of the financial subjects and all of the business stuff would be related to the coronavirus. And that was true. And I waited all day for someone of all of those comments and punditry and all of those postulations and all of that advice. I was looking for something new, something unique, something that would be more than the ordinary helpfulness. Yes, I know. I should wash my hands and sing happy birthday to you twice, and perhaps that will work. But I heard none of that. No real good new stuff as to how I, as a man or a woman doing life and business today, can make it. How we can survive, maybe even thrive, through this coronavirus crisis. Nothing happened. So what I did is I decided to get up on Tuesday morning, put on a coat and tie, and there's a good reason for that, and go into the studio and see if perhaps I could share with you something that might be helpful and useful to you. And today I'm simply going to introduce you to an idea and start you with three words. That's right. The key is three words. Well, let's find out more what that could all be about. Yes, the three words. Now, part of what I'm doing today is introducing you to a new idea that I have been asked to be a part of, which is called the Praying Planet. And this new movement around the world is designed to help people all over the world learn and use the power of prayer, the creative power of God in prayer, the keep praying principle. About how we can be connected for creating and healing and rescuing and doing the good things that God wants done on planet Earth. And this is for all of the people of planet Earth. Here's the deal. I have learned more and more as I've gone through hard times and listened to hardy folks get through hard times, that we forget that it really is the basic concept which says, pray without ceasing. As my friend Corky Hahn said for years, and as a hero to many of us, he just simply said, always keep praying. Keep praying. Whatever, keep praying. And I would like to suggest that one of the strategies that you and your business put together to go through this coronavirus is the very simple one that no one seems to be talking a lot about. Keep praying. On Sunday, at our little fellowship, I oftentimes take time to give help by writing prayers that we can do in the prayers of the people. And I gave that special thought, and if I may, can I just share with you the prayer that I wrote, the small part of the prayer that I wrote to make it relevant to the day, relevant to the week, and relevant to the people. And get away from all of the kind of God talk and talk as real people, and then asking God to listen, and then for us to listen, and then to see what he has to say. Here's what I said. Lord God of healing and protection, much of the world is frightened by the coronavirus epidemic. We know that you hold the future and that all will be well eventually by your grace and glory. But right now, we are deeply concerned and a little bit fearful. So give wisdom to those who lead the efforts to stop the outbreaks and bring healing to those who are afflicted and are suffering. Protect the caregivers and those in the front lines of testing and care. Hear us, O God, for we know that your mercy is great. Just a simple word. We're saying, God, you hold the future. And we know that by your grace and glory, all will be well. But in the meantime, what do? Well, we pray for protection. We pray for wisdom. We pray for healing. We pray that those people who walk the front lines of this battle against the coronavirus, that they will be protected. And certainly we want our children and our families and those we love to have some special protection, not because we're special, because, you know, we just feel deeply involved in their life and spirit. So that's my introduction. But what I would like to tell you today is it's about the power of God's creative power in prayer. What I've discovered is that we need to pray a three-word prayer. And so today I'd like to suggest that to you and then ask you to think about it and perhaps actually do it and see what happens. One of my friends said, Stan, don't pray for money because God doesn't have any money in heaven to give you. Simple as that. Pray for things that God wants for you that will help you to do the work of dealing with your day, making your mark, and being thoughtful, fruitful, successful, and kind in the world. And so here's what came to me. We should pray for wisdom. God loves and is the source of wisdom. In fact, if it's not from God, it's probably not wisdom. Wisdom comes from God. We pray for wisdom. To know, to understand the times and to know what to do. Understand what's going on. Don't panic. Don't fret. Don't be afraid. Do you know how many times those words are in God's words? Don't fret. Don't panic. Don't be afraid. All right. Then he must mean them, because he said them so often. And that's what he wants us to do. So we pray for wisdom. And see what happens. See what ideas come to us. Perhaps things that we might do that we never thought of before might come to us. I guarantee you, if you will take time to simply pray for wisdom and do your day, but from time to time, just pause. Maybe sit down. Maybe think. Maybe bow your head. As one person said to me, Stan, when you don't know what to do, bow. When you don't know what to do, bow. Probably should say it again 3 times. Yeah, when you don't know what to do, bow. So, pray for wisdom. Then pray for courage. Yeah. Don't be careful. Be courageous. Be courageous. That's what God is all about. That we walk into the world with his power, and because of that, the stories of the men and women of God throughout Scripture and throughout history, that's the quality you find the most in those who made their mark and made the difference. Courage. Courage. So pray for courage. You have one more quality, and there's a lot of people who have wisdom, and they have courage, but they lack gentle kindness. Boy, this is a hard one for me. I am not a gentle man. I have a little joke that I oftentimes say is, my wife Karen is the nicest person in the world. Unfortunately, I'm not. But gentleness, kindness, let your poise, your gentle kindness be known to all. So may I suggest that we simply go through this day and every day, and particularly maybe this is what the coronavirus is ultimately all about, because people always die of disease and difficult things happen, and there's going to be a lot of difficult things that are going to happen. There's going to be a lot of catastrophe and calamity in some way and in some respect. Just simply the financial structures and the business organizations and all of the things we have to do to solve the problem. And it's hard. If it were easy, we would have solved it. We solve the simple problems easy. It is the problems that matter and the problems that are difficult that take a little time and take a lot of prayer, take a lot of wisdom, take a lot of courage. And it's all tempered by kindness. That's the deal. Now, as you walk around your day, you don't have to go into fancy words. Just bring to mind these three words. Kindness. Courage. Wisdom. Wisdom. Courage. Kindness. Wisdom. Courage. Kindness. When I take Jackson, the wonder dog, for a walk. Wisdom, courage, kindness. Before I make some tough phone calls, wisdom, courage, kindness. Before I do some of the videos and some of the work that I have to do and put together the radio programs and deal oftentimes with difficult clients who are now kind of panicky and are upset. Wisdom, courage, kindness. The master entrepreneur taught that, lived that. And St. Paul reflected that where he says, you know, hey, press toward the mark of God's high calling and let your gentleness, your kindness, your moderation, your poise be known to all. Tomorrow, if you'll give me permission, our second program will be how to actually pray the 7-point wisdom prayer. The 7-point wisdom prayer that's a part of what we do in the work we do, and hopefully you, as you go about planet Earth and as you go about your work and as we deal with the coronavirus, that this will start. Today, I'm hoping that millions of Christians and millions of people who follow God and love people and love planet Earth will go around praying for wisdom, courage, and kindness. Wisdom, courage, and kindness. Make it so. May it be so. I'm Stan Houston for the Master Entrepreneur. Follow him, pray to him, honor him, and honor all the people. Treat every person you meet as the most important person in the world, because perhaps they are. To God, that's what he wants you to do. And I would suggest that if we do some of these things that perhaps I've shared in this few minutes, maybe the coronavirus will be something that we can not only survive, but maybe we can learn how to thrive. God delights in turning calamity into victory. Why don't you join him? All the best. Bye for now. And if you'll give me just a few minutes, I could use your help. And so, I would appreciate it. We've oftentimes said that we could use your contribute now, but we have a little idea. How about if this has been helpful to you, you give a little tax deductible tip to the Christian Entrepreneur Network. $2, that would be nice. $2, $5, and $10. Go to the link and maybe $2, $5, just $10. I saw one donor box where you had a box for $50,000. We don't have any of those. But if you could help us out, if you could encourage us and help us go to the next step with the work we do and hopefully make this coronavirus series a little viral in itself, I would be grateful. Again, if you could leave a small tip and maybe a suggestion, and certainly as you do so, say a prayer. For you and for me, indeed, for all the people on planet Earth. Thanks. TCENglobal.org/contribute now. TCENglobal.org/contribute now. It'll take you to the way. I am grateful. St. Paul said, I give thanks upon every remembrance of you. We'll see you again tomorrow. Bye for now.